lighting, it's staging, it's so many things in one. It's because it gives all those possibilities, and opera is something that takes you out of your world, and it's bigger than life. But at the same time, it has that connection to real life because it expresses human emotions. Do I have to say more?
So one of the things I enjoyed when I came for rehearsal was Rhoda's insistence. I know you've got a great voice, but you're telling a story. Tell the story, get into character. But, and I want to bring Yvonne in on this. Come on guys, 21st century, we are Africans. Why are we dealing with these forms that are not ours? A novel, why a novel? Why can't you just, you know, find a way of doing folk tales?
You know what? First of all, they're ours, one. We're given beings, so they're ours. Second, they're just platforms, opera is just a means.
Can you
just stories tell? Opera is just a platform for a story to be told. The novel is merely a platform for stories to be told. The blog, the internet, they're just means through which stories and our lives can be told. And our role, I think, those of us who want to, is to use them well, to tell the story well.
Rhoda, do you think there are enough Kenyans who understand this form? To take us to the thing of investing into creating a 21st century Kenyan opera, why don't we just take, for those who want to, just take what has existed for centuries and do that? Why go to the trouble of creating a new Kenyan opera?
Storytelling has been there. We're continuing a tradition that was there. It's just that we're living in a world now that where East meets West, and North meets South. And there's no reason why we can't marry our different cultures and cultural expressions. But obviously, my heart burns for telling African stories. And as Yvonne said, it's a platform.
Yvonne, how hard is it when you start to say, I'm going to do things with this form that people don't expect? And I'm going to tell you why I'm asking this question. When I work with Dust, the number one thing, Dust is Yvonne's first book, the number one reaction people tell me is that, but Dust is so difficult. Tell Yvonne to write like an African, right? Not to write like this, you know. So what are the challenges of getting into that new space? You know, it's the same thing. Why, yes, we have great musicians and we've heard them, but for me, I'm struggling with this form. You know, why do this? What are some of the feedback you get, and why do you keep pushing on and pressing on with this vision and this yearning and this dream? Yvonne and then Rhoda.
You know, during one of those kind of conversation sessions I had with some young people who kind of asked a similar question, I kind of told them, don't go into this unless there's nothing else in life that you'd rather do. Unless you understand that if you are meeting your moment of death, this would be the moment of your warrant. Because there's nothing, anyone who wants to go into this because they think there'll be fame, fortune, and success, you're wasting your time completely. You do it because you almost have no choice. If I did not do it, I'd be running mad in Nairobi, like crazy. I do it because literally I have no choice. And I think a lot of those who are called into whatever art calls the individual, you're driven by this thing. I think the Luos call it joy. The Spanish would call it duende, or whatever it is, this call. You do it because you have to. And those who are artists understand that whatever form the story wants itself in is the form that you choose, almost without your opinion.
I can't help but interrupt. We have a member of the cast, I don't need to name names, and he came to audition. And I looked at him and I thought, okay, well, we're fair, so we'll let everybody try. Never judge the book by its cover. He opened his mouth and my mouth fell open. And I looked at my co-judges and so after that we questioned, because you know this is a long journey. If we're going to take you, which obviously something had hit home. So what do you do? I'm a Buddha Buddha driver. And what he sang to us was our typical Pavarotti aria. He said, where did you learn to sing like that? On YouTube. So the thing is, that's just a caption of what there is out there. And what drove him to love that, to have that passion, he did it with something inside of him, and as soon as it was done, he was back to himself. And I know that there are many of those Buddha Buddhas. I've met another one who's a washwoman. The stories are galore. There is no way we're going to stop giving them this fire. It's a passion. It's a drive, like you said. It's something that makes you live. You're an artist. You understand, right? So, yeah.
So I want to have one last question, and you know, we have artists amongst us.
Yes.
What is it that we do or we can do as artists who are there, the master artists? What is it that we can do to help these others? What you've just talked about, Rhoda. What's the vision, what's the dream that we can do today as a master artist to enable this new group, this new crop who are going to take us to the next generation? What are some of the things you suggest? And not only the artists, but those of us who are here. And to be honest, me, I'm in that group of make a joyful noise to the Lord. Yeah. You can hear my voice, not sing to the Lord. So the rest of us who want to come along with you, what is it that you can do?
I like that question, but I'd like to leave it for all of us. What do you say, Yvonne?
You know, I like the fact that you opened it. Let others also answer it.
Yeah.
But I think to do what it is that we're doing, and to do it... even when you sometimes, you know, certainly for a writer, it can get very solitary, very lonely. And one of those moments you're walking in the streets with the, you know, 50 bob in your pocket and thinking, why am I doing this? But to do it anyway, because there'll be, it's almost as if you're called, opening a pathway, opening roads for those who are coming behind. So just because you make it, just because you walk this far, the others will walk a little further than you. Yeah, so to do it. And when you run into them, and I do that, if I run into anybody here, even bankers who are pianists, I always say, come to the light.
So then you guys are going to be showing us how to do it, and you're going to be making the way. And the rest of us can come and encourage you and support you and not leave you to be so lonely. And we'll come to how we can do that later on. But for now, I want us to go back to the music. And in this particular extract,